We got this vintage original Boeing 747 Pan Am poster, and we have put it on linen, but before we show you that, let me show you this. Stretching canvas. We are going to mount this poster on a linen backing. And linen backing is really cotton backing. It's cotton canvas that we stretch to a screen. Stretching the screen is a long process which must be done if we're going to linen back. This poster has unusual qualities, and I'm sure you'll find this video interesting because it's not like a conventional poster and has some peculiar problems which we have to address as we do the work. What can I tell you about the 747? There's always Wikipedia. I think the first time I flew on a 747 was in the 1970s, but I'm not even positive about that. I know I rode on a 747 when I flew to South Korea to get married. I've taken many flights to South Korea on Korean Airlines, and they were always 747 jumbo jets. The Boeing 747, it was a wide-body aircraft. They made commercial jetliners as well as cargo versions of the 747. My father used to call it the jumbo jet. It's a big airplane, and it was originally supposed to have like 150% more people, more passengers than the 707 made by Boeing, which is still a very commonly used airplane. The 747 was first flown commercially by Pan American Airlines in 1970. So how many passengers is 150%? Well, it's about 400 passengers. It can accommodate about 400, 416 passengers in a typical three-class layout, 524 passengers in a typical two-class layout, or 660 passengers in a high-density one-class configuration, which does not sound comfortable to me.
That's on the screen.
Okay, there's long tape.
There's tape on it?
Yeah.
Taking the tape off the poster. Just one piece, but it's very stubborn.
Oh yeah, this is very stubborn. There we go.
Is this not paper-based, is it?
I don't know. It feels like it might be. Do you think it's absorbing?
I think you're right, that's paper tape. Let's leave it on the poster because it has paper tape, it will absorb the wheat paste.
Yeah.
Too risky to take it off. Okay. This is a poster advertising the new Pan Am 747 coming soon. Seattle to Europe.
Yeah, it just keeps on
rolling in, so I just want to stay. Let it absorb for a while because that paper is unusual. It has a canvas texture to it. This paper is very thick and it needs time to absorb, which is why we sprayed it with water first. No telling what the inks will be like once we turn it over. Let's keep our fingers crossed.
Yeah.
On September 30th, 1968, the first 747 was rolled out of the Everett Assembly Building before the world's press and representatives of the 26 airlines that had ordered the airliner.
Stretching the paper out while we put on a final coat of wheat paste.
This was actually the reason that I was trying to pet it, because I saw the where the creases were. I kind of felt like the paint might come off at the creases because it kind of looked weak. That's why I wanted to get most of the air bubbles out before I roll it, because then it's gonna be worse when I roll it. You know, with the glossy posters, they tend to make that crazy white marks. Yeah, I was afraid this was going to happen, but it's happening too. Hate these kind of ink.
I'm wondering if we should put plastic over it to roll it out.
With the most air bubbles out, because I'm trying to push the big air bubbles.
You're pushing the air out now with the sponge.
Yeah.
So that we won't have ink problems coming off with the roller. Because the ink seems to be very sensitive.
Yeah, something like this is where the crease was.
Yeah. Where that,
it's always a problem.
Don't you hate it when that happens?
Yeah, it's annoying.
The ink is so sensitive on this poster, we're not going to use plastic because we're afraid the ink would come off on the plastic. So we're going to very carefully roll this out. to try to minimize the amount of color loss. We're afraid ink is going to come off on the roller. I knew there'd be some issue with this. It's the printing is unusual, the paper is weird.
Yeah. I think they used kind of like plastic mix paper. This is not a regular paper. So that might be why. It's a little grainy too for some random reason.
Pushing out the air bubbles carefully so as not to upset the inks, which are very sensitive.
Yeah, it's like, I don't think I can sponge this after.
No.
Yeah, it's not even rubbing off, it's peeling off. This is weird. See?
Where?
Over here, it's like there's that blue pigment that just peeled off. The ink is like playing separately.
All those white bits you see is the ink coming off. Appreciate Jinbei's talent at recognizing this problem before it becomes a worse problem. We could have easily approached the rolling overconfidently and ended up destroying the poster. At least there's no ink down there.
Yeah, but I'm still afraid this is going to come off.
All right. Nice. Good screen. The screen, she is done. All the posters are finished. See, what more does Wikipedia have to say? Oh, on January 15th, 1970, First Lady of the United States, Pat Nixon, christened Pan Am's first 747 at Dulles International Airport, later Washington Dulles International Airport, in the presence of Pan Am Chairman Najib Halabeh. Instead of champagne, red, white, and blue water was sprayed on the aircraft. The 747 entered service on January 22nd, 1970 on Pan Am's New York, London route. And did you know the 747 has been involved in 146 aviation accidents and incidents, including 61 accidents and hull losses, which resulted in 3,722 fatalities. The last crash, that means 3,722 deaths. Deaths. The last crash was Turkish Airlines Flight 6491 on January 2017. There are also 24 deaths in 32 aircraft hijackings, such as Pan Am Flight 73, where a Boeing 747 was hijacked by four terrorists and resulting in 20 deaths. Few crashes have been attributed to design flaws of the 747. And etc.
And there you have it, an original Boeing 747 Pan Am vintage poster, fully conservation-backed by Posterfix, where we bring your posters back to life.